I'm Dr. Neelam Rasman, and by profession I'm a doctor, but by belief I'm a Christian woman, and I got married in this house. It's a missionary house, Rasman house. It's a very old ancient house, near about more than 100 years ago. My husband's grandparents, they started this work, and still by the grace of God we are running this work. And in our compound there's a lot of services are on, like we are running one charity hospital and one school and church ministry. By school, lot of children are getting word of God and good education. The school is English medium. We have more than 500 children. And the school, I'll talk about hospital. There's near about 200 patients per day. We are 7-8 doctors. We are serving the poor and needy people. And the very difficult conditions, we are serving our best to people who are needy, and who they, in the name of Christ, I think so, we are able to do it. Because in such situations, in such a limited sources, what we are doing is only by the grace of God. Otherwise, we are not able to do anything. Everything is for Him and by Him, I think so. And at present, we were discussing about the situations and position for women, as a condition of women in India or anywhere in the world. And we Christian, according to our, according to this scripture, Bible, I think there is no difference in the women and men. And God has already chosen us as a, to us as an ambassador, and we all are God's ambassador. Jesus said that we all are just equal. We are not men and women. There's a lot of things and traditions and a lot of orthodox thoughts are on in our societies that we should do that, we should not do that. But I am not convinced with that. I think whatever is written in the Bible, that is the basic thing. I think you, when we go somewhere, then people think the head covering is must. They think there's a, we should cover our hair, head. Women should not talk. Women should not speak about scripture as banned. Because in somewhere is written as a one verse. But we take out the only that verse and we speak about that only. And we doesn't understand what's the meaning of inside. If we see in a, I'll read one scripture for you.
Galatians.
First I'll read Romans 2. Is, I think so, nice. Romans 2, 28 and 29.
I should read it?
Huh.
It's 28 and 29.
Hmm.
Man is not a Jew if he is only one outwardly, nor is circumcision merely outward and physical. No man is a Jew if he is one inwardly, and circumcision is circumcision of the heart.
Yes.
By the Spirit, not by the written code, such a man's praise is not from men, but from God.
Yes. It's clearly written that we all are not Israelis. By God's grace, by Jesus' sacrifice, we all are Israelis. Mm-hmm. What Israelis? We are not born Israelis. We are by belief Israelis. If we are by belief Israelis, then we are no more anything like that. We are just Christian because we believe in a Christ. And a second scripture I will read, Romans 8, 11, 12.
Mm. And if the spirit of him who raised Jesus from the dead is living in you,
mm-hmm.
he who raised Christ from the dead will also give life to your mortal bodies through his spirit who lives in you. Therefore, brothers, we can have an obligation, but it is not to the sinful nature to live according to it.
11 से 16 बेटा,
okay.
11 till 16.
Now 13, for if you live according to the sinful nature, you will die. But if the spirit you put to death the misdeeds of the body, you will live. Because those who are led by the spirit of God are sons of God. For you did not receive a spirit that makes you a slave again to fear, but you received the spirit of of sonship. By him we cry, Abba, Father. The spirit himself testifies our spirit that we are God's children.
Yes, in 12 and 13 is clearly written. There's a, we all are children of God. There's no written, there's nothing about man and women. Then women, they are not children, and man, they are child of God. The women cannot be children. If it is true, then why in the old ancient time, if you go, there's a Moses time, there is a, there was just Deborah. She used to do the justice. And if we come and Ezra, Esther, Queen of Sheba, this is in Matthew also written at the time when Jonah, at the time is written this of them when justice will come, then the Queen of Sheba will be there. She will say that through Jonah they accepted their sins and they cried and in front of God. But we are just hearing about Christ, whatever he did for us. He gave his life and his blood and shed his blood. Because the in front of him there is no difference in men and women. That's the basic thing. Especially in India, we don't understand that. There's a lot of things there. People think it is very necessary for women. This is not necessary for men. If we'll read Galatians 3 in Hindi, Galatians 3.
Galatians 3 and it's 28.
Mm-hmm.
There is neither Jew nor Greek, slave nor free, male nor female, for you are all one in Christ. If you belong to the Christ, then you're Abraham's seed and heirs according to the promise.
Yes, it's clearly written, Paul says that in front of me, we are not Egyptians and Israelis. We are not male and female. We are just children of God. We have a right to say that, yes, we should be proud about it. We should be thankful that God has given us such a way, such a beautiful and easy and simple and way to understand that God loves us so much. But if then too we don't understand that we are just, there is difference. If again I'll say one example, if it is, there's difference, why Jesus has chosen a woman after his resurrection, he met to the woman and he said, go and tell. Because God is such a wonderful God, he always, whatever people say is because women did sin, that's why we are suffering. And still some people, different thoughts are there. Then again, when Jesus came, he just break all our curses, all everything, whatever was before. Still if we believe in Torah, this is for women, this is for men. And still if we are in that, that the where is the sacrifice of Lord Jesus Christ.
Mm-hmm.
Through him everything is vanished. He just shed his blood for our sin, for our that differences. There is no more differences in male and female, and there is more differences for Egyptians and the Indians and Israelis, because through belief we are one. Like that, we, my friend Nancy and my other friends, they belongs to America, but I belongs to India. But I will say again it, we all are one in Christ. We are children of God. In front of Him, we all are same. They can be fair, I can be dark, but our belief is same, our baptism is same, our passion is same, our work is same, I think so. We, whatever, our race is same. Like Paul says, we are running to receive that award. He says, I won't say that I received it, but still I am trying. What we are, we should not live our life for our body. If we still are living our life for body, then still we are in Torah time. I'm right? Then where's the sacrifice of Lord Jesus Christ? If we are still living our life for our body, we always should try. I know in Romans 3 is written, there is no one is perfect. Yes, it's true. But it is also true, we should try to become like a Christ. We should try to become perfect. Because our our work should be on for that, always. We should always try to do that, then we should, like Paul says, I always beat my body because my body says something, my soul says something, my spirit tells me something, because our body is like that. Our body does us exactly what we don't want to do, because we have weaknesses, because we all are human beings, but we have we should try for that we should be perfect, because no one is perfect except Christ. And through Christ, through Christ, I'll say the God shows Himself to all, all manav jati ko kya kahenge? All mankind, all the mankind. So what God is, what the God's love is, what God wants from us, because He knows that no one can be perfect, no one can do that things, whatever He is written before that. Because Jesus said, I am not here to finish that. I came here to complete that thing. And He completed now we are in a new creation. 2 Corinthians 5 is written, we are in a new creation. If we are in new creation, then why we are living in an old time? Why we are living in the same thing? As this is for women, this is for men. If we are wearing this thing, this is wrong. If we are covering our head, then this is right. Paul says in 1 Corinthians 11 chapter 16 verse, okay, this is not rule for my side and not for God. And when we are praying and we are talking, and when we are trying to be a Christian, a child, in front of God, I am not a woman, I'm a child of God. Then I can go any without covering my head, because He knows it is not necessary to in front of God I should cover my head, because He is my Father. I can talk to Him in any condition. He knows my weaknesses, He knows me, and He knows that if I am talking to my Father, I should not cover my head. Because I have a right. It's written there. So you are children of God. You have a right to be part of His kingdom. When I have a right, because I believe, I trust, I declare, I shout, that's yes, I am a child of God. Why should I cover my head? Why I should do this? Why I should not touch this? I should do that. I am a woman. That's why I do that. Because it's written there. So we are children of God. This is the basic thing. By wearing, by saying, by eating, by anything, by showing through your body whatever you're doing, just for human beings, but for your soul, for your, what are you are doing from inside, what your spiritual life is doing. That's the basic thing. I think so. It is very necessary by spiritual thing, what spiritually what you are doing from inside. Like Jesus says, just clean yourself from inside. A body is nothing, because body is just for 4 days. A spiritual life will be forever, eternal life. A God knows what we are. Again, I'll say that if we are children of God, we are not men and women, because we have a right to say that, yes. And we should be happy and glad, yes. And again, I'll say to women, never think that you are less. Because in front of God, we all are children. Because from the ancient times, I won't say this is after Christ. Before Christ also, there's a lot of women, they did a very good job. Like Deborah, I told you, Esther, Ezra, I'll say that again, Queen of Sheba. Then why we should think that we are less? We are not less. I think we are more. God has given us so many things extra. We will talk about this matter again whenever we get a chance. But this time, praise the Lord, we all are one in front of God. Don't forget this. Bye-bye.